Mrs. Berry?
Just about everything, by the sound of it.
Well, it's a holdup.
Yeah, Mrs. Berry? What's the holdup? Well, I reckon I could have been a sunstroke hanging around out here.
Daniels, that explains it.
Oh, you know her, do you?
Mm-hmm. She's a liar, a sneak, a loafer, and a hypochondriac. Get inside.
Sure, Miss Ferguson.
What are you doing in here? There's work to be done. Oi! Don't tell me the freaks put the kibosh on your parole already. Hey, hey. There's no need to take it so badly. There'll be other times. Crying's not gonna do it any good. Come on, love. We've all had our disappointments. You get over it. Lizzie, my dad's dead.
Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
We weren't ever real close, you know, but I never wanted to...
I know, I know. Don't fret yourself, love.
I've got to go home. I've got to go and make up for all the trouble I've caused. Oh, Lizzie!
Oh. Okay, love, I think you can let your breath out now. Just go around the other side. How's your foot?
Well, terrific. Look, just get me to the bike, all right?
Some good news, Heather. You can go home today.
But I've only been here a week.
Yeah, that's right. But your incision has healed nicely, your temperature's back to normal, so it's time you're off.
But I thought you'd keep me here till you found out what was wrong.
Heather, when we opened you up, everything was okay. Your tubes and ovaries were fine. You've got a few adhesions from previous operations, but they're not causing you any problems. I think we can safely say at this stage that you had a nasty virus of the lymph glands in the tummy, which I doubt will recur.
And how do you know you didn't miss anything?
I consulted with Dr. Elliot, and he's of the same opinion.
Now, you just leave that in there, and I'll be back in a tick. One thing about having Dr. Bowen and Dr. Elliot, at least you know you've got the best. Pain? We're same place?
Anything wrong?
Okay, it's all right, Heather. Let's have a look at this.
What are you going to do?
We'll stitch her up in here. She hasn't done that much damage, only to suture tray, Brendan.
Okay, I'll get Loveday to give us a hand. Judy!
Heather, I'm going to have to put a few stitches in your arm.
Well, it's Shane. I couldn't possibly leave him.
Sudden change of heart, is it?
Well, he's my son. Surely you can understand that.
It's a bit late in the piece, Lee.
Don't look at me. You brought it on yourself.
But I can't go to jail. You can't let them do that to Shane.
I remember when you couldn't have cared less about Shane.
Oh, that's been different for a long time.
Oh, but I've got a long memory, Lee.
So have I.
Well, don't forget one thing, Tim. If I go, you go too. You helped me put the birthmark onto Fula. And with your record, you can bet your life they're not going to give you a pat on the head.
I see. Even turning on your brother now.
Hurry up and get a doctor. I'm going to bleed to death.
First things first.
Oh, for goodness sake. Nurse Rayner, take this girl through to the examination room.
No, you'll have to come in and see a doctor.
Hey, what's your name?
Tara.
Well, then so come to in you.
There. Okay.
Bye. This way, please, Tara.
Excuse me, I've got an appointment to see.
Leave your name at the desk, please.
You'll be seen by the first available doctor.
Marge, if Dr. Warner's not back in 5 minutes, could you page him, please? This is getting ridiculous.
Yes, Miss Burton.
Yeah. Hold on. Yeah.
Carrie Burton, I'm charge nurse here.
Got it.
I understand you've been working in South America.
That's right, Guatemala.
Yeah, and Rio.
Well, you'll find things a little different at Shortland Street. We don't get many cases of malaria or snake bite.
They're waiting upstairs.
He's waiting, but I'd like a word before you see him.
Well, is it important? I have kept him rather a long time.
It's about Dr. Rokita. He was here when a maternity case was brought in. It was an accident, but no serious injuries. Dr. Rokita insisted on delivering the baby here.
He what?
I explained our position.
He hasn't even started yet. Why?
There was no other doctor here.
I mean, with his complications, bleeding?
It was breech.
My God.
I tried to reason with him, but he just bulldozed over me and went ahead. You know, the last thing I need is any more scandal. I would never have allowed this.
No. I know that. I'm not blaming you. What do you mean there was no other doctor? What about Warner?
She can be a bit overwhelming at times. Well, it was difficult for her. You know, there she was, a big star, and then about 10 years ago, her agent stopped returning her calls. At least this anti-smoking crusade keeps her busy.
Mm. And she's just up for visit.
Oh, well, Terry's away at another conference, and Mum, well, she came up to help look after Tiffany. Well, Tiff worships her. But now she tells me she intends to stay.
Mm.
For a while, anyway.
These are the files you wanted.
Thank you. You haven't brought the collier file.
Oh, I'm sorry. I must have left it downstairs.
I'm sick to death of inefficiency. Report's not ready. Correct files not delivered.
I'm sorry. I'll arrange for the courier to bring it up.
Dr. Steele and I can't be expected to wait whilst the courier...
All right, I'll bring it up myself.
As soon as possible, please.
I think you owe my wife an apology as well. She's a part-time file clerk, not a messenger.
Oh, she volunteered to get a file for me.
Only because you insisted.
Well, we needed it urgently. I'll make sure that she doesn't get in trouble with a supervisor over it.
There's, something I think you should know about my wife. She has multiple sclerosis.
Oh, I didn't know.
In the future, I'd be grateful if you'd give her a little more consideration.
Dr. Denham's office. Dr. Napier speaking.
Judith, it's Graham Steele speaking. Mrs. Gallagher in Ward 5 would like to see you.
What now?
Later will do. I think it's just a matter of her medication being adjusted. Ward sister does her rounds in about an hour. Could you do it before then?
Well, I don't think I could manage that. Dr. Denham's in his office, but he's not taking any calls. Could we leave it till later?
Never mind. I'll manage to do it. I would like to see you later on this afternoon, though. Will you ring me when it's convenient?
Yes, of course. I was convicted for the murder of my husband. I went to prison for it.
Must be my lucky day. I've been looking for you, Daniels.
You leave me alone.
Get lost, Quinn. Now! And now you are going to get hurt. And for that, you're going to get very badly hurt.
Thank you.
That's my job.
Oh, go on, Lizzie. It's time to get some orders in. You help me and I'll...
When will you learn that I decide who does what around here?
Pecking order can be changed.
Over my dead body.
Don't tempt me. All right, break my arm, put me in hospital, Smith. See if I care. With you in solitary, I reckon I can sew up this place for the duration. You should get yourself insured.
Don't listen to it, Dobson. You're playing like a German band.
And that's another thing. I don't like people looking over my shoulder, so would you kindly go and sunbake on the freeway?
Now, you mustn't frown. You'll get wrinkles on top of your wrinkles. Wrinkles?
I don't hear too good. Well, maybe we should clean out your ears or give you a hole in the head.
OK, Smith. But make it quick, eh?
Are you going to marry Rod?
I don't know. I'm thinking about it. I really am sorry, Doris, but I don't think it has anything more to do with you. Now, I hate to be rude, but I've got a lot to do today.
It's not fair. You've got your baby and you'll have Rod. I've got no one.
I know how upset you must be about losing your job and I... Doris! Open the door! You hurt my baby, I'll kill you.
Oh, Kate.
Hello.
Joan, I was just looking for you.
Here to buy something.
Joan, I'm so sorry about all of this.
It's the only way.
It must be terribly hard for you.
For the men more than me. Their pride. But I say, well, we're leaving here with something we haven't had for as long as I can remember. Freedom from all that worry.
And the mortgages, the debts.
Over and done with. I try to keep thinking about that. Still, I know it's going to hit me later. Like a death in the family.
I'm glad I've found out about it. It's forced me to take stock of a few things in my life. How I've let myself stagnate emotionally.
Oh, you're being a bit hard on yourself, aren't you?
Well, I'm due for it. That's why I've accepted Rosemary's offer of a trip to America. I plan to shake off a few cobwebs.
Oh, good for you.
Why don't you come too? I mean, Rosemary's paying for my fare. I'd be happy to pay for yours.
Helen, I'd love to, but... Oh, well, Nikki's got her final exams, and I'd like to be here for her.
Well, I understand. But there's one thing I won't be too understandable about, and that is if you don't come back and stay with us. You will, won't you?
Oh, Helen. Wild horses couldn't keep us away. You're my sister.
Oh, no, you're not a word now. Shut up. Stop fighting me.
What's that?
It's a bomb, sweetheart. When the little hand and the big hand meet at 12, it's bye-byes. High noon.
But I didn't do anything. I'm just a kid.
I'm sorry it had to be you. But you're just a sacrificial lamb caught up in a larger, more significant event.
Circumstances. The authorities won't be too harsh. Where are you, Kathy? Please pick up the phone and call me at the studio. I know how you feel. I'm a mother too.
Don't you worry
about that. I know just how to get into Mr. Stewart's good books.
G'day.
Oh,
Hello. I think Mr. Stewart's out the back if you want him.
Oh, no, that's all right. I'm just after some caustic to unblock our kitchen drain. It's dry of an orange spear.
Oh, no, dear. No.
Sorry?
Oh, nasty, dangerous stuff, that caustic. And expensive. What you need is washing soda. Now, I think I've got some here somewhere. Ah, yes, here we are.
How's it going, Rob?
Oh, not too bad, mate. You sure this'll do the trick?
Guaranteed by your old Auntie Mary. And about a tenth of the price.
I wouldn't bet on it. You can't go past the caustic if you ask me.
Well, why pay good money to shoot chemicals into your water? Not that I'm one to get up on my soapbox. But I just don't like to see people throwing good money down the drain.
I reckon I'm with you there.
Thanks, mate. I'll retire on it.
Business pretty bad, eh?
Good heavens, what gave you that idea?
John Quinney thought you might be in difficulties.
Honest John Quinney.
Oh, you've got him wrong.
Oh, no, I haven't. He's after the Emersons, the Ramseys and the Chandlers.
Rubbish.
If he could lay his greedy little hands on Nanguya, Glencoe, Stud or this boutique, he'd die happy.
But he's a wealthy man. Why would he bother?
Why did Hitler bother?
Oh, good, women.
Heard from my erring husband yet?
Inspector reckons he'll be finished the course by the end of next week.
Well, Sir Galahad, what's on for tonight?
Would you believe? The pub.
Madge.
What
would you like to drink? Come on, Mrs. Davies, you don't often have a drink with me.
I prefer not to drink.
Lord help Des. Two beers, Madge.
Why didn't you say you were coming to meet him?
Oh, John Quinney's all right. Besides, he's been like a dad to Des.
Here we go, Mrs. Davies.
I didn't get you out of bed.
Well, you did. What do you want?
What time will you be in today? The assistant commissioner wants to see you.
I'm too crook.
My, my.
You tell the AC to go and get...
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I hope you'll feel better soon.
What's more, the whole of Department B can go and get...
Right. I'll tell him he won't be in for a couple of days.
And you can...
Same to you. He's got a touch of flu. Won't be in for a couple of days.
Flu? Since when does a mere cold get Hills off the job?
There is a first time for everything, sir.
Breakfast, Smith. Breakfast? Good, it must be nearly lunchtime. We thought you'd like a sleep in after your midnight trip. Come on, Frieda. You'll have plenty of time to meet the infamous B. Smith later. What's with her? Evidently, your reputation has arrived ahead of you. Some people are impressed by that. I'm not. Fair enough. Is this it, or do I get out of here? Well, think about it. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name. Mrs. Roberts. Mrs. Roberts, you wouldn't happen to have a match by any chance, would you? Smoking's a health hazard, you know. Yeah, well, I like to live dangerously. Is that so? That's a habit we discourage here at Barnhurst. Oh, no. Another bloody Vera.
May I introduce Mrs. Anne Reynolds, the new governor of Wentworth.
Oh, dear. This really has been a surprise for you, hasn't it? I'm sorry.
No need to apologise, Mrs. Reynolds. Breakdown in communications, that's all.
Yes. What's all this?
Lunch, Mrs. Reynolds. We missed out yesterday, but things are back to normal now.
Well, thank you, but I'm afraid I won't have time to eat. I have to go out. Don't bother putting it down. Perhaps someone else would like it.
But what about your lunch? Mrs. Davidson always had it about his lunch.
Mrs. Davidson, now please take it out. Damn. My first disagreement with a department, and I take it out on a prisoner.
Oh, well, I wouldn't worry about Lizzie if I were you. She was giving Mrs. Davidson advice all the time.
Once again, Mrs. Powell, I think I'll have to put a memo out to this effect. I am not Mrs. Davidson.
I've just been to the infirmary to see your handiwork, Smith. And I've come to the conclusion you disgust me. Do you have an explanation for what you did?
She murdered her own kid.
And you're serving time for double murder, so what you
they do... They were kids. Huh.
So that makes a difference, does it? What a pity they didn't meet you when they were younger. They might still be alive. No, Smith. Not while I'm here. Take it to solitary, Mrs. Powell. 48 hours.
Nothing's been touched, Governor. The gun is where Smith left it.
Good. Shall I cover her? No, I want things left exactly as they are. There's no more we can do for her now.
There's something I think you should see, Mrs. Reynolds.
What's that?
Well, could be a tattoo. A lot of the women have that sort of thing in here.
That's not a tattoo. She's been branded.
I agree. And I don't remember her having it when she came in.
And it must have been done in here. My God, I thought I knew what to expect in this place.
Oh, I can't tell you how good it was to share such an inspiring musical experience with somebody who truly knows how to appreciate it.
It's been a wonderful evening, Harold. Thank you.
No, thank you for being such a wonderful companion. Oh, no, allow me, it does stink sometimes. Turned against me. Even my wife and daughter.
That must be dreadfully difficult for you.
Well, yes, because I'm not a solitary man, Robin. I've always needed warmth and affection.
So do we all.
Yes, honesty can be painful sometimes. As it was in our case, eh?
I've missed you.
And I you.
It seems a shame. We share so many interests. We've both been lonely.
Yes, but therein lies the problem. Good heavens, I said, will you look at the hour? I'm afraid I have overstayed my welcome.
You couldn't do that.
Nevertheless, I must be off.
I'll see you at the Oval tomorrow?
Yes, of course. I can't tell you how grateful I am for your understanding.
What else are friends for? Good night, Harold.
Till tomorrow, eh?
The world is full of blonde nursing sisters. Giving the nurses a hard time again?
I want to talk to you. I've been invited to the Shores for dinner tonight.
Oh, that should be interesting.
Ben Fielding will be there.
Sounds more like a surgical conference than a social event.
Obviously, he hasn't got around to asking you, so you can go with me.
Just like that.
Susanna's going to be there, too. I think she'll be much happier if you arrive with me.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
It's not, and you know it. How about it?
Okay.
We could go over the road for a drink first, if you like.
How come you managed to get invited?
I'm Erica's doctor, and she likes me.
Oh, I suppose one shore in three is not a bad average.
he's gone.
He didn't stay long. He went home.
Without finishing his drink.
How was the party?
Everyone else seems to be enjoying it. I didn't have much fun.
Because it was your last day?
No.
I hate goodbyes, Peter.
I guess that. They should be said, Tanya. Especially between good friends. So much time.
Makes the cliff busy. Wentworth Detention Centre.
Hello.
No, 8:30.
Stand on that line.
Right, thank you.
Mm-hmm. You know, I've never been inside a prison before. Oh, thank you.
You're Sandra Louise Mason, is that correct?
Yes, but you can call me Pixie if you like. Everybody else.
Sandra Louise Mason, you are charged with 4 counts of bigamy and 4 of fraud and are to be held on remand pending a trial to answer these charges. Is that correct?
Yes.
Bigamy?
Yes. Silly, isn't it, to punish people just because they like getting married?
I would have thought that anyone who got married once wouldn't be stupid enough to repeat the mistake.
Oh, that's because you haven't met the right man. I bet you're married, Mrs.
Powell. I'm the deputy governor.
Oh, goodness. I didn't expect anybody so important to meet me. Don't let me keep you from your work.
This is my work.
Oh, goodbye. Hope to see you again.
I don't believe this.
Yeah, just going to be one of those days.
In here like this.
Oh, yes, it's a bit informal, I know, but, well, all of my clothes are missing, all the pretty dresses I came with.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. You were issued with a uniform.
I can't wear that. It's not mine.
Lord, you love, you look much better in your white old gowns than you had me fit.
Thank you. I'd never buy denim. It doesn't suit me. Besides, everybody else is wearing it.
Goodness.
Good
on you, Pixie.
Yeah, well, she must be mad
if
she's just gonna fool
Pal. Nice to see you made it, Mason. Unfortunately, we don't allow customers in here unless they're properly dressed. It is a shame, but you're gonna miss breakfast. Bye bye.
But
no buts. Get out.
Go on through. Please, take a seat.
Thank you. Very nice. Most attractive.
Yes, well, I like it.
You're obviously a reader, Mr. Fisher. So, books and classical music. Any other interests?
I play the occasional round of golf. I like to do some gardening.
The outdoor type, then?
Well, yes.
So tell me, Donald. Oh, you don't mind me calling you Donald, do you?
No. Not at all, no.
Have you ever been married? So what type of person were you hoping us to put you on to?
I thought somebody hardworking, of course. Obviously, punctual, thorough, flexible. You see, I'm not sure I want this to be a permanent arrangement. It's just a stopgap measure till I get myself sorted out.
So you're not looking for a lifetime commitment, so to speak?
No. I was thinking more along the lines of one day a week for a couple of months, that sort of thing.
Oh.
Well, that's not a problem, is it?
Well, I'm not sure. You see, most of our clients are looking for a slightly more rewarding relationship.
Relationship?
Oh, well, don't take offence. We like to get things exactly right. I mean, there would be little point in introducing you to a woman whose main aim was marriage. Now, would it? I mean, that would be wasting everybody's time.
Marriage? You saw what I'm beginning to think we're having a major misunderstanding here.
Oh, really?
Well, when I asked you about finding me a cleaner, I really didn't expect this personal, in-depth interrogation.
A cleaner?
Well, sorry.
You said a cleaner.
Well, you said that's what you do, isn't it?
Mr. Fisher, I run an introduction service.
All's under control, Paul. We're just babysitting until the father arrives.
Good.
But, come to think of it, I think you'd know more about handling kids than Pete or I.
I don't know, Louise. It's the mother in you that's needed. Just use your imagination. I'm sure the chromosomes are there.
Who's he? The big boss?
Oh, that's yes. Mr. McFarlane.
All right, what about it, Lou? I haven't got time to babysit.
Kelly! Well, she could babysit.
All right, I'll give her a ring.
Oh, we don't need a babysitter. We can look after ourselves.
Yes, I know, but who's going to protect all those other people in the terminal against... Yes.
Her name is Sonia Elizabeth Stevens, is that correct?
Correct.
Correct, Miss Ferguson.
Correct, Miss Ferguson.
You have been charged with possession and trafficking of heroin and sentenced to 15 years imprisonment, is that correct?
Correct, Miss Ferguson.
Right. Put your personal belongings on the counter. They'll be held in storage for you until your release. Some 15 years from now.
There's to be an appeal. I doubt I'll be here much longer.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the snake lady.
Do you know her?
There isn't a hooker in town who doesn't know her. She's married to Eddie Stevens.
Yeah, well, that we know. What else?
Oh, tons. This one's a real sweetheart. There's hardly a girl north of the city who isn't paying her protection money.
Protection against what?
Oh, she claims if they don't pay up, her old man will pick them up.
Does he?
Who knows? Who really knows? Because everyone pays up, don't they, Sonia? Everyone, including those pathetic little junkie bastards. Oh, and they can't win either way. Because she takes their money from them. And then she turns good old Jerry Turner loose on them.
And have you got anything you would like to add to that?
Not really. I think she's covered just about everything. So if you'll excuse me, I'll say goodnight.
Times change, Smith.
You gotta change, or else you get left behind.
I decide when things change, and the women do as I say.
Dead, Smith. Past tense. You see, I can give them what they want. Money, a little bit of fun now and then. The old times obsolete. And you know what that makes you, don't you?
Well, I'm not quite ready to step down yet. So don't hold your breath.
Fine.
You listen to me. Smith got where she is because other people let her walk all over them. Well, I am not other people, Stevens, and don't you forget that.
Well, if you hate her that much, why don't you get rid of her?
It's too risky.
I don't mean kill her. I mean have her transferred.
No guarantee that Barnhurst would keep her.
It doesn't matter. As long as she's away long enough. Oh. No.
No. What do you got there, Stevens? Oh, looks like a baby. Is it your baby, Stevens?
No.
What's your baby's name? Nicky, isn't
no.
it? That's right. But Nicky's dead, isn't he, Stevens?
Tell fellows he won't be sorry you got me up, Mr. Renner. I'm sure I'll prove more than an asset to the operation in Sydney.
You got it all wrong, sweetheart.
Then why am I sitting here?
Oh, you'll be an asset, all right. But not the way you think. You see, we want Eddie.
Eddie's dead.
No. That's just what he'd like us to think. Your Eddie's running scared. He's got good reason to.
The accident?
Faked, when our Melbourne branch cottoned onto his double dealing. Oh, Eddie's alive, all right. And you, sweetheart, are going to flush him out.
You boys seem to have a very short memory, don't you?
And what would you have done if he said that about your sister?
Not behave like a wild animal in a zoo. I'm disgusted with both of you.
Sorry, Miss Crawford.
I'm afraid it's too late for apologies.
Well, you're not going to suspend us, eh?
No, that seemed to have no impression on you at all last time. I want 500 lines on my desk by Monday morning. I will not bring disrepute to my uniform or my school.
500 lines? God, that'll take ages.
Any more complaints, I'll make it 1,000. All right, get to class.
People are too backward around here to see that.
There's an old Jewish saying, if six people tell you you're sick, lie down. Lie down, Miss Crawford.
Right, your name's Rebecca Ann Keane, is that correct?
Yeah.
Been convicted of armed robbery and you're currently serving a 7-year sentence at Wentworth Detention Centre, is that correct?
Yeah.
You're also charged with escaping from legal custody and further charges pending, is that correct?
Yeah, all right.
You lay a hand on me, you'll be a very sorry screw.
Now, why would I want to do that, Keane? Such a pleasure to have you back. Of course, you would never have escaped if I'd been on that bus trip. But I couldn't make it. And you know why I couldn't make it, Keane? Because my father had a stroke. He nearly died. And all because he was kidnapped by your mates.
So it wasn't my idea.
Oh, but I think someone should pay for what happened to that old man. Don't you?
Dumbo, I'm back. Sell much, did you?
Oh, yeah, fair bit. Money's in the box. Hey, you know you got some nice plants here. I wouldn't mind one myself.
Okay, take your pick. Not that one itself.
Oh, yeah, of course it is. You know, this is very nice. I could have sold it a couple of times over. I reckon it looks just as nice with that plant in it as the other one, but...
Other one?
What other one? The other plant. Well, somebody wanted it. It was very pretty, so I just swapped them over and put that one in its place.
Nut, who? Who'd you sell it to?
My brother Albie wanted to take it home. He paid me the full price and everything.
That's all the rest of it. Forget it. Dumbo sold the plant.
What? What the bloody hell are we going to do now?
We get it back. Her brother's got it. If he's anything like her, it shouldn't be too hard to con it out of him.
Geez, do you know what he looks like?
Don't need to. You're going to do it.
Me? What the bloody hell?
You screwed up, lady. So fix it. Now get going.
Here you go. Come on. Now break it off. I said knock it off.
Don't tell me, Hunt. Plant food, right? Hand it over.
I told you it wouldn't bloody work. I told you!
You should have listened to her, Keane.
Don't let me stop you, Phil. I mean, if you were to have an accident... You see the doctor, you'd want to have clean undies now, wouldn't you?
What do you want?
Well, you see, I owe you one, Phil. Remember? Well, this is it. Not bad, eh?
Don't rip, please.
You know the difference between an asset and a liability, Phil? Well, you're a liability, and I can't afford you.
Yeah, well, it's true!
Oh, yeah, sure. I bet you'd be dead keen to find out about your old man. Get it? Dead keen.
Yeah, well, what do you mean?
Know what I mean? Your brother's dead. He's dead as a doornail.
You killed him when you wrapped that car around a tree.
I know.
That's why your mum and dad wiped you. You murdered your own brother.
Oh, no. No! Oh, no, I did it!
Well, well, Keen. Now I've heard it all. You pretending you didn't know your brother was dead. But you're dead, Keen, because you killed him in that crash as sure as if you had held a gun to his head. You see, I took the trouble to check up on you after you nearly killed my father. And it's not pretty, Keen. It's not pretty at all.
Oh, just leave me alone now, please.
In fact, your record makes Lizzie Borden's look very tame. Now, have you also forgotten about Phyllis Hunt?
Oh, well, who's she?
A vegetable, Keen, a vegetable. She didn't do what you wanted to do, so you smashed her skull in.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and what about your drugs, eh? Your little rackets. They killed Mitchell's baby and put Parker in the funny farm.
Oh, stop it!
Oh, there's more. I'm sorry, Keen, but there's more. It must be a great shock to suddenly realise that you're responsible for so many shattered lives.
Oh, no! Look, if I can only remember!
You know, if I had to face the awful truth about the things I'd done, I think I might kill myself. Perhaps that's the answer for you, Keen.
From all accounts, he was a bit of a pants man. Racing off your girlfriend, was he?
Oh, now listen.
Sergeant! If you'd rather not take part in the interview process, you'll let me know.
If someone did this bloke in, it wasn't me.
Take a look at your hands, mate.
I did changing a wheel last week.
Too fresh. Try again.
I took the top of it off when I was helping up the stairs.
Whoever Mark was fighting hit him in the face. A bloke could skin his knuckles.
The fight happened before I apprehended him. If I were you two, I'd stop wasting your time and go find the fella he was fighting with.
You talked to him last. Any ideas?
He wouldn't say what happened. It could be any bloke in Mount Thomas.
How popular was he?
That's like you said. He's a pants man. They're not a popular breed in a country town, not once they start poaching.
Any bloke in Mount Thomas includes you.
I said the fight happened when I was in the station.
What about the second fight, Nick? The fight with the cushion?
The pillow fight, Nick. That's the one we want to know about.
Look,
you were his last known contact.
It's true what they say. The past is another country.
It's either this isn't a guidebook.
It's all right. I'm fine. You're not, you know. You're in shock. And you're feeling hurt. And you're feeling betrayed.
Oh, what a fool, eh? I mean, that Lucy is hanging on to the thought that deep down Charlie really cared for me. You know, he might have been weak, but oh, he was the one person in the whole world who truly loved me. Do you know something? Not once in my life have I ever been special to anyone.
It's not true, not anymore. Look at me, please. You have a daughter. And you have four and a half beautiful grandchildren. We all think you are very special. And very much loved.
Thank you, Miss Sheffield, but we do have a courier service.
Oh, I offered. I'm on my break and I like to feel involved.
That's commendable.
So if I'm ever free and you need any help with the patients or anything, I'd love to help.
Yeah, well, not right now, thank you.
I've got the rest of the afternoon off.
You are keen, aren't you? Well, my shift finishes at lunchtime. Come and see me in my office.
Excuse me, sister. Could I have a word with you?
What do you want?
Only to apologize for last night. We set out to surprise a friend. I hope you understand. I'm sorry.
Oh, I understand perfectly, Dr. Mitchell. But this is not a university campus. Try to remember that.
Thank you, sister.
Painfully earnest, isn't he?
We at least have the merits to apologize.
It is Miss Vaughan's job to investigate the situation and determine whether the marriage has broken down irretrievably.
That's right. Compulsory counselling for both parties is required by the family law court.
Well, I don't know about Kevin, but I don't want anyone sticking their nose into my affairs. Just leave us alone and get on with the divorce.
Mrs. Burns, no one likes to see a marriage fail. My report will show what factors were involved that caused the breakdown. Maybe something can be done before it's too late.
Miss Vaughan is trying to help you. There may be certain misunderstandings or conditions that can be cleared up by counselling and perhaps save your marriage.
Look, it's finished. Over. There's nothing anybody can do. What chance did we have of making it with me stuck in here? I was a fool to think it'd work in the first place.
Do you still love your husband?
No.
Were there any other factors involved?
No.
I do understand how difficult this must be for you, and I'm sorry you won't let me try to help you. I'll put in my report and send you a copy.
Thank you.
Well, how long will it be before the divorce comes through?
Case probably won't be heard for a few months.
Will I have to be there?
Well, as there's no question of custody or property settlement, no, it won't be necessary.
Can I go now?
Awful. I've just been to see Mrs. Reynolds. I got some bad news.
Bobby?
She's okay. The baby, she lost the baby.
Oh, no.
I'm afraid so. I'm not going to tell her. Yeah. Not till tomorrow, anyway. But, at least she's okay.
Sure. It's terrible, isn't it? Oh, no, don't do it!
Bobby Mitchell was pregnant and I treated her like, well, one of the lads. Cass, what's the matter? Just heard about Bobby. I want you to know how sorry.
No, don't do this! Go! Let go, Parker! Let go!
On the way, they'll have restrainers.
Open it. Those women are in danger.
They're her friends.
Look at her. She hasn't got any friends.
I swear to you, no one is sorrier than me.
I wouldn't bet on it, Screw. What about Cass? She went right off her bloody head. I suppose you're sorry about that too. Don't give me that crap about being sorry. I'm the one who's sorry. I had a baby living inside of me, a real little baby. I didn't know who the father was, but I loved him. I'm
really loved it. Where do you reckon babies go, Mr. C? Do you reckon there's anything in this religion thing?
I don't know, Lush. I really don't.
Sister? Sister Hall?
Receiving of this ring either way.
As you have consented together in the presence of your family and friends, and by the giving and the receiving of a ring, I now declare you to be husband and wife.
After tonight, I want to forget I've ever seen or heard of you.
That's not very nice.
You'll have your tape back and you needn't worry that I'll talk. Paul and I live in the country.
I'll be waiting.
Remember, I packed, so now you unpack.
Is this what they call shearing, is it?
Got it in one. You said we'd be alone.
Well, we are, I assure you. Oh, the glasses. Well, I'm afraid my housekeeping standards aren't quite up to yours, Terry, but I can assure you, my drinking companion is long gone. Now, look, can we get this over and done with? I am in somewhat of a hurry.
There's nothing I'd like more.
Well, then give me the tape, my dear.
These, please. Hello? I wish to report a murder. A Mr. Charles Durham.
Way to end a party.
Not very pleasant, was it?
Please, Paul, that's everything. Look, none of this can be doing the baby any good. Let's just go to bed.
You just can't stop lying, can you? You said it was over.
He tried to kill me, Paul.
You said that was Daphne.
She was wearing my coat.
You told me something. Did you kill him to save our marriage or just your own skin?
Does it matter?
you doing?
Calling the police.
Did you tell them?
It's your last chance, Terry.
Please, Paul.
Everything between us is over.
Paul, put it down, please. Please, Paul, I love you.
Paul?
Yeah, that's not my brother's place. They've got four.
Yeah. See any good flicks lately, girls?
We saw this terrific one about three men and a baby. And at first they didn't like the baby or anything. They couldn't handle it. And after that, they really liked the baby.
Jeez, I love. One was going to pay the other one $1,000.
Oh, if you could change the nappy for
it. Jeez, just because he's small doesn't mean he's got no brains.
Isn't he fab?
He sure is. Every mother should have a lamb.
You know, that's what I reckon too. I mean, most blokes wouldn't want to know. What good's that to you? None. I mean, imagine if you had five kids and you got really sick and the husband couldn't handle it. Is that useless or what?
Why?
Oh, I couldn't have said it better myself.
Yeah, and like, Lance is really different. He's really cool about it. And I think that that is actually pretty amazing.
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 What's going on?
We've come to pick something up, Judy.
What?
My gun. The one Phil took.
Your gun? You mean he did take it?
It's all right. Just go
Look,
back
it's
inside.
It's not all right. You left that gun here, you little liar.
Just take it easy.
All you've ever done is cause trouble for us. You do it deliberately, don't you?
All right. Let's get it.
Leave me alone. You're your stick-up for him in spite of everything.
Well, he's my brother.
And what are we, me and Chloe, what are we, garbage?
You're messing us about. It was in there. Someone must have taken it.
Yeah, like who, Phil? One of your little mates.
How the bloody hell should I know?
Well, you must have some idea. Judy, has anybody else been here this morning?
No, just me and Chloe. Oh, my God.
Where is she, Judy?
Chloe!
Right next.
Just leave it!
It's all right.
Let
all right, come.
Go.
It's all right. Hold tight. It's all right. She's all right. The gun hit her in the face.